Hello and welcome. I'm Peggy. Thank you so much for letting us share a part of your day. And we have a special lady here, and we're going to talk about education. Now, your children may be grown and gone, or maybe you have a tiny baby and you think, oh, I don't have to worry about that for a few years. But we all need to be aware of what's going on around us, of the needs, and how we can help and be supportive. Because in the world that our children are going to face, an education is even more important all the time. And I'm so pleased to have Mary Nell Anthony here with me. She is a brand new principal of the Greenville Tech Charter High School here in Greenville. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me.
Now, you're a South Carolina girl, aren't you?
I am born and bred Carolina girl.
And you graduated from Anderson University.
Yes, ma'am.
And Furman.
Yes, ma'am.
And now, and you chose to get into the field of education. Is that something you really wanted to do?
Yes, ma'am. I started out as a writing major at Anderson University. And then I was trying to figure out just what I'm going to do with that. And I took a class on world literature, and I led a study group to learn about King Lear. And they were having trouble understanding it. And I got up and I wrote some things on the board. And one guy went, oh, now I get it. And I thought, I want to make that light bulb moment for everyone. And I just really, I think teaching is a calling.
It is.
I felt called to work with young people. And when that light bulb moment happened, I thought, that's what I'm supposed to
do. That's what you were meant to do.
Yes.
Yeah. And so now you, Greenville Tech Charter High School has approximately how many students?
Our charter permits 440 students in it. So we have, I think right now, we're still accepting a few off the waiting list. And so we're at about 420 right now.
So I understand you do have a waiting list. Now,
yes,
this
ma'am.
Is high school, freshman through?
Senior.
For 4 years?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And I don't understand exactly, and maybe you can clarify this for all of us.
Sure.
What sets the charter school apart? What makes them different? Because it is a public school.
Yes, and that's one of the misconceptions. When you have charter, a lot of people mistakenly think that it is a private school. It is not a private school. It's a public school. It's public school funded.
So the parent doesn't pay a tuition?
No, ma'am.
All right.
No, ma'am. Just like at any public high school, there might be the materials fee at the start of the year.
But there's no tuition.
One of the differences is in our funding formula, though. We, through the state of South Carolina, we don't get facility money. We get the money for the student to be educated, but we don't get facility money.
What do you mean by that?
I mean the money to pay for a building.
Ooh.
So at Greenville Tech Charter, right now we are housed on the campus of Greenville Technical College.
Which is very nice.
It
yeah.
is. But we're actually limited in space. We have a few floating teachers at my school. So we have built, we have purchased property on Augusta Road so that we can expand our campus to offer a few more things for the students. We're not leaving Greenville Technical College. But just to have more space.
Expanding a little
yes,
bit.
Yes, so we're trying to raise some money for that. But in general, a charter school, it is a school of choice, and it's to provide a different option for parents. And so when you look at a school, whether it is, there's multiple charter schools in Greenville,
yes.
And then there's really good public schools that are traditional models as well, you want to think about what is it that you're wanting for your child. Greenville Technical College sponsored us originally with the goal of having a middle college. And so that's kind of what's unique about our school. Students are allowed to take dual enrollment courses beginning their sophomore year. So they can actually leave Greenville Tech High School with an associate's degree and be ready for the workforce. Or to go into another program. If you want to be a lawyer or doctor, to enter as a junior at Clemson from high school
is huge. So in other words,
huge.
You can build, while you're in the high school, you can have classes so that when you graduate from that high school, you'll already be kind of ahead of the crowd.
Oh, yes. And that's whether or not, you know, you have a child that wants to be a welder or cosmetologist or do something in mechatronics, or whether or not you have a child that wants to be a doctor. So they're going to go ahead and get their first 2 years of transfer requirements out the way. So there's really a couple of different pathways available at my school. And in order to make sure, I mean, obviously throwing a sophomore into a college level class, that's pretty intense. So we do, we believe in setting the bar high.
Good.
But then we give lots of support. And so that's one of the unique things about my school. We have an advisory period every day of about 15 students that meet with one adult. And that adult stays with them every year. They loop all the way up until they graduate as a senior. So you form that relationship with that adult your freshman year, and then you progress with them to make sure that you're getting great advice, great mentoring, and good support on a personal level.
Now, this is a free school.
Yes.
And parents do not pay to have their child go to your school or any charter school.
Right.
Yeah. But I've been told that you have a waiting list.
Yes, and I think that's where the misconception comes in that we're a private school because, there's an application and a waiting list. But that is because we want to make sure that we are taking all students so that it's truly a public school of choice. So on that application, it doesn't matter if your child, you know, is the top honors child at the middle school, or if they're just the average kid getting through. We go through the waiting list as the lottery process. And
oh,
so it's just numbered.
Oh.
You know, it's not a first come, first serve.
So you don't look and say, oh, this child's made great, wonderful grades, and we better have that child.
Oh, no, wouldn't that be simple? We just take all the great kids, and by great, all kids are great, but the academic-minded kids, and then, yeah, of course we're going to do well. But no, it's any child, and the lottery system and the waiting list just makes it fair, makes it as a fair process.
I see.
So that we take all in the applications. And every year we can take approximately 110 freshmen, and we might get 200 applications. Yeah. So we take all of those, and then we draw names kind of out of a hat. We number them. And so you just have a number on that waiting list for your application. But we don't really know, when we pull your number, Peggy, if you are number 78 and I pull you, I don't know anything about you as a student yet until I pull your number, and I might find out, you know, that you need special services because you do have a learning disability, or you have, like my daughter Bella, ADHD, so you need extra teacher support for that. Or we might find out that, hey, you had all 99s and you've already taken, you know, geometry, algebra, English 1, and we're getting you coming in too. So we take anyone.
Now, in a charter school, it isn't, if a child has the ability or is eager and wants to study and they move ahead, they can have progress at their own rate and not be held back with 25 people. If they're capable and they're interested and they want to make a commitment and study a little harder and say, okay, it's more individualized. That's what I'm trying to say.
Right. And ours is, there's different models. So you have some that use more of the blended learning model where the student does everything online and they self-pace that, right? So that is something that some charter schools do. We believe that teacher is an integral, they play that key role. And that you need that interaction between student and teacher to really get the material and learn and make sure you're assessing where you are. So we advance you by offering you advanced coursework if you're capable of it. Like I had a student today that came in and said, you know, Ms. Anthony, I really want to focus on sciences. Can I take an extra science class? Can I take these two honors level science classes at the same time? Sure, you can. Our goal is once again that middle college concept, So we want as many students in college courses as possible. And obviously that might happen at a different rate. So we have some students that start that sophomore year. Other students wait until junior year to kick that off. And then we offer for that extra support to make sure that they do well. We have academic assistance through office hours after school.
Okay.
That's offered. And we also have a college seminar on Friday. Because, you know, most college classes meet Tuesday, Thursday, yeah. or Monday, Wednesday at Greenville Tech. They don't have classes on Friday. So the kids still come to us on Friday. We check in with them. How are they doing? We answer their questions. We make sure that they're staying on track in those college classes while they're taking them.
So what really sets your school and any charter school apart is more individualized. If a student can move ahead, they can do that.
It's more choice.
It's yes.
Yes, more options than what
options,
you might have.
More choice.
And your options that every charter school gives are based on their individual charter. So when our charter was written, it was written and said, we want to ensure all kids have mastery learning. So, you know, if you're not getting that Algebra 1 concept, you don't get to keep moving. You have to make at least an 80 and show us that you've gotten that concept.
So before you move that child ahead, they have to really digest the material, whether it's
Correct.
Math or something else.
Right. And then we do smaller class sizes. In a traditional model, you might have 35 kids in a class or 32 kids in a class. We're going to have a cap of 25.
Okay.
And most classes are around 20 in my school. So that's another key difference.
And I understand there is a waiting list. But for parents,
oh, yes.
for parents out there, you know, we're at that time of year, everybody's thinking about school. We hope.
Yes.
And we have to go to a break. But don't, if a parent out there has hopes and dreams and the child wants to learn, don't just say, well, the school, it's impossible, the school's full and I can't do anything about it.
No.
Put your name out there anyway.
Exactly. Go ahead, fill out that application so we at least know you're sitting out there. Because we might get to someone on a waiting list and find that they moved to Mississippi.
Yeah.
And then we'll come to you next.
Okay, we'll be right back, so stay with us.